Hey my dear friend, and welcome back to this particular section. Now in this particular section we are talking about radio button. Okay, so in the previous section we are talking about the checkbox, which is really amazing, but still we are not using only the checkbox, we are actually using the radio button also, because we are talking about, hey, if the user wanted to check only the one option, if I wanted to say that, hey user, you can just check only the one particular answer by the four options, so that's why where it's not checkbox is useful, right? So we need to use a radio button for that. So radio button is useful for every, if you wanted to get a gender from the user, then you can use it. You can use a lot more things for radio button. So that's why, let's get started. Okay, so now here is the thing. If I wanted to radio button, so that's why I need to create a one particular file, which is Python file, and now it says radio, and that's pretty much it. And if I just wanted to copy the all the things. And now here is the point, if you wanted to use a radio button, then you need to TTK, okay? The radio button is inside the TTK, so that's why you need to import using the TTK, okay? So this thing is needs to consider, okay? And that's pretty much it. If I just root it, just copy it here and paste it here, that's pretty much it. And after that, let's just say button, okay? That's pretty much it. Copy it, paste it here, that's pretty much it. And I need to create some command for it, and now I'm just creating command, okay? That's pretty much it. It's not so hard, and I hope this working pretty well. You doesn't need to give any kind of conditions here. We are talking about that how we can just use it, simply is pass them. Now it's time to create a one particular radio button, okay? To create a radio button, we need to use one particular variable to multiple radio buttons. You are using like, you can say that, hey, I wanted to create a four radio button, but initially you wanted to check only the one by this four, okay? So you need to create a variable, and that particular variable you need to assign them on the four sides, on the four radio buttons, okay? So let's get started. I need to cover up that, let's say gender, okay? So this maybe it's a considered thing, and you need to create a string variable for that, okay? So I'm just creating a string variable for every single TTK dot, in the TTK you can see the radio button, and that's pretty much it. You need to give your root, which is your main variable, and then you can just say that, hey, text will be, let's say, if you, we are sending a gender, so that's why male, and that's pretty much it. And after the male, you need to assign a var, okay? You need to assign some kind of variable, so just var is equals to, you need to send that gender, and that's pretty much it. It's all about your thing, okay? It's done, okay? It's not so hard. And if I just copy it here, paste it here, and here I just wanted to say that female, and that's pretty much it, okay? It's completely fine, and it's going to be working. So let's get started, and let's, okay, it's working like a checkbox. Okay, you can see this is not our, okay? You need to pack that up, okay? So let's pack this up, dot pack it here, okay? Because we are not assigning any kind of variable for every single radio button, so that's why we need to use dot pack directly here, okay? So we are using it, and if I just rerun it, and now we can see this male and female, okay? So you can see this is, oh, it's a totally mistake, right? You can see this, it's checking double sides, but how, okay? So here's the thing, we wanted to just check one of this, okay? So how can I do this, okay? So specifically what is happening is, we are just saying that var keyword, but we are not assigning any kind of value, okay? So we need to assign some value for every single, you know what, every single button. So value maybe it's matter, okay? So value, some value is male, and second where value is female, okay? So it can pick up some kind of value, and it value, this is value which is posted into this particular section, okay? It is just like if you are checking the radio button male, it will goes to the gender male, it will convert your gender into the male. So you can say that this string var converts the male, okay? So it's totally fine, and now it's time to just attach them, and that's pretty much it. And if I just rerun the program, so now if I just run it here, so let me just run it here, and you can see this is window, this is clear. But if I just picking up male, then female is not considering right now. But if I just picking up female, this male is not considering right now. So it's working pretty well. So now we are doing lot more things, okay? We are doing like the graph, and now we can see this male female options. We are doing a lot more things. Okay, now it's your time, it's your task to do that. You can just go it here and just type some code. You can print this option with the help of label. Okay, so after clicking on button, you can pick up that particular option, which is you know what, checked out, and you can print it by this label. Okay, so it's your task to do that. Let's meet up in the next one.